Okay, here we go.
Oh boy.
Ah.
Whoa!
Yeah. Whoa! Oh yeah!
Oh!
Fetch!
Nine!
Just do it and we'll be sniffing each other in no time.
Well, it's no treat being downwind from you either, mate.
Fetch, weenie! Go! Fetch, weenie!
Nine!
He keeps saying that, and so do I.
Now I see.
I don't even know what that means.
I think everybody just started laughing from day one, and everybody contributed to a lot of ideas, and I think everybody felt like they were a part of making this movie.
I love animation. I love this. I love it so much.
You know, it was very loose, and we tried different stuff. And some stuff works, some doesn't, but it was a lot of fun doing it either way.
It's always hilarious working here.
What a great cast. I was just glad to be a part of it.
We feel amazingly blessed in our voice casting in this film. We cast them because we love the quality of the voice and the personality as it was. All their inner animals were right there and came out very quickly.
Oh, yeah, I gotta tap into them. Ah, no, I'm just kidding. I think we all got a little animal in us.
Isn't this great, Boog? I mean, you know, not that Weenie's been kidnapped and all, but great that we're living life on the edge just like old times.
For those of you who haven't seen it, I assume you watched the movie and are now watching the special features. That's how it usually goes. But if you haven't, weird. The movie is about a mule deer who I play. His name is Elliot, star of the show.
Oh!
I might have misread that.
Elliot is a really funny character, unsure of himself, goofy, a very goofy, doofy kind of guy. You know, we all know guys like that.
But you already have it!
He's a very emotional mule deer. One of the more emotional mule deers in, I'm gonna say, the entire forest.
Oh, the humanity!
This guy's a freak. He's loud, and he's got his busted antlers. He's horrible at planning. He freaks out over everything. And I love him.
I am the best tracker! Ah, ah, ah! I win!
Joel came in with a great attitude from the beginning, and so much of his normal personality is in that character. All it was just making sure that the energy level was right and making sure that, you know, he got the occasional little energy squeaks and would raise it, but we just let him run.
Hut, hut, hut! Right!
Weenie tracks! Yes! Vindication!
Joel has this same kind of similar spastic quality in a good way that Elliot has, where he had a lot of energy in the records.
I got you again! Nailed it! Yes!
I think he felt pretty at home spazzing out.
You're not even listening! Pay attention! Are you listening?
Yes. It is a shriek. My vocal cords are still recovering.
Yes! Got you again!
And due to the nature of his personality, he was great at improv, so we would get two or three takes of what we wanted, and then he'd just go to town and he'd go out of his mind and just deliver a ton of really funny stuff.
The old switcheroo, Boog. Nice, huh?
Yep.
The old electrocute the doggy. I invented that. Not the word switcheroo, but what happened in the pool there?
Pretty nice, huh? I'll be giving a lecture on it later.
Come on, it was pretty impressive. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Who are you?
What do you mean? I'm your best friend.
McSquizzy?
McSquizzy? He doesn't even like you.
Well, I think Boog, he's kind of the protector of the group. I mean, just a big, loving guy. You know people like that in real life. Just a big teddy bear.
This is mostly fur. And fur adds about 100 pounds easy.
It was easy for me to, like, tap into Boog.
Oh, come on! I'm Boog!
I look at him as a big support factor for the rest of the crew.
That's my main man!
That tone of voice that I used was just kind of easygoing.
Fluffy and sweet, like you, Giselle.
Mike, his voice is great. It's very resonant. It's just one of those warm voices that you want to hear.
Great shot, Elliot. You won, man.
It makes a perfect contrast to my spaz voice, as I like to call it. So he kind of keeps me grounded, and he keeps the whole kind of movie in place with his big presence.
Oh, now, y'all calm down. Simmer down.
He's a huge character. He's got to have that deep, rumbly voice, which Mike is able to get. And at the same time, needs to get wound up. He gets irritated. Elliot drives him nuts. He's got some high energy he needs to do. And again, Mike Epps can bring it to that level as well. He really did a good job of bringing Boog back again with just the right spirit and the right vocal quality.
Now see, that's what I'm talking about.
And oftentimes in recordings, we'll throw in additional lines that aren't even scripted just so they could riff on it and have fun.
Now will you relax? Of course you're doing the right thing.
Yeah, they would let me ad-lib. Some of the lines needed like a little bit extra rhythm to it to make it feel real, you know.
What I'm wondering is Giselle doing the right thing? No, I'm just kidding you.
Oh, Boog!
Jane Krakowski plays Giselle, who is a sleek, beautiful, totally together dear.
Thank you so much.
Jane is brilliant. Sounds like an angel. Like a dear angel.
Oh, Elliot, that's the most romantic thing.
A dear angel. I wish they really existed. Just fluttering through the woods.
Interesting. Yeah. Just wondering how this relates to our wedding and the fact that you left me stranded at the altar.
And Jane's performance is really great. She just has a wonderful energy.
We've got to do something.
She gave a lot of attitude in her delivery that was quite entertaining and made her still very endearing.
What did I just say?
And Jane would do a great job of taking what could be neutral dialogue and just putting that little bit of edge in there, like, you know, I know what's going on here, or, you know, you're not pulling one over on me.
Now, come on. Let's stay on track.
And just found that right balance of being very sweet, but then when she needs to turn it on and just show a little bit of anger and emotion, she's right there. So, yeah, she was just wonderful to work with.
Nailed.
Zavini is free!
Mr. Weenie is played by Cody Cameron. Cody is not German himself, but he can pull off a perfect German accent for a dog.
And this time around, he even used, I think, even more German in this movie than he did in the first one.
Jawohl, unser wunderbar!
He nails it, and we have our little exchanges, and he gets me to speak in a German accent.
Now say it with me. I'm wild!
I'm wild?
With conviction, I'm wild!
I'm wild!
He's great. Great. And he looks exactly like his character.
I am nothing like Mr. Weenie.
Oh, I can't believe I fell for that!
Mr. Weenie is hilarious. I have two Weenie dogs. And Weenie dogs have a distinctive personality. They're strong-willed, they're stubborn, you know, yapping and running away.
Wait for me! I have teeny legs!
They captured the personality very well of a real Weenie dog.
Never forget who you are! In here!
He's in a bit of a turmoil, trying to decide if he is a wild or if he is a domesticated animal.
Oh, the food of oppression!
Mr. Weenie has a really hard time denying himself the pleasures of the doggy biscuit.
I must be strong! Maybe just a taste. Nine! Yeah? Nine!
But he can't control himself, and he must submit to the biscuit.
So good! I'm weak! How could I? Wunderbar.
Roberto, you know what to do.
What? I don't know what you mean.
Fifi and Roberto are a pretty interesting pair. Roberto's only concern is with eating and pooping.
Come on, help a brother out.
And Fifi has higher goals.
Pay attention! Even one wild can infest us all. Like the fleas on Roberto's back, they must all be eradicated.
Fifi, who's played by Crispin Glover, who's, you know, got a ton of energy. He's got that perfect kind of menacing feeling to the character, and it just matches up perfectly with the images that they made.
The next wild I see crawl out of that forest, if they don't have their papers, they are getting a full Fifi smackdown!
Crispin Glover, who I've been a fan of, a terrific actor, and just the idea of his voice out of this little dog's mouth is really, really funny.
Thank you. For noting the obvious, Roberto.
I thought it was awesome because the secret, deep down, I know all poodles are like that.
You are right.
That's where it's funny, is that it doesn't have to be a big, menacing dog. It just be this little puffball with that look in her eyes.
He noticed! He noticed! I noticed! You noticed!
I heard.
We all noticed!
I got
it. I noticed!
Wow.
I love that.
Ah, oh, Fifi, it was great.
Steve Sharippa playing Roberto is great because Steve, being from The Sopranos, is used to murdering people in cold blood. And so this, I think, is a perfect transition for him, is an animated dog.
See, I don't really see the point.
He seems to be a little punching bag for Fifi.
Please, Fifi, no running.
He's kind of lazy and he can't keep up with the rest of the group. I'm gonna take a 5-minute nap. He's drooling and he's slow and he's sweating and he's hungry probably. Oh man, it's this good. Hey Fifi, you want some? Just gotta go to the bathroom, you know. Not unlike myself. Hey Fifi, how long you think it'll be till we stop? Cause I gotta poop. Seriously, I gotta poop really bad. So, that's what Roberto's all about.
Doing a good job there.
Thank you.
The boy's locked up like a rusty gate.
Diedrich Bader is tremendous at Rufus.
Where's he from? I like him.
This wonderful kind of southern dog, kind of a Streetcar Named Desire, Tennessee Williams version. And I just wish at one point he would have screamed Blanche.
Weenie, weenie, weenie.
His voice is very distinctive, kind of cowboyish maybe, you know, a little bit of a cowboy in there.
Now we tried everything. We were the good guys and the bad guys and the cowboys and the Indians and the black hat and the white hat, the Hatfields and McCoys. We were mud and water. We just didn't know what to do.
A little southern, he's hanging around with the Southern Belle, you know.
Why, Charlene, look at you. Don't you look prettier than a glob of butter on a stack of wheat cakes? Makes me hungry.
Very manly, Rufus. Very, very macho dog.
Well, butter my behind and call me a biscuit.
That all came out in Diedrich's vocal quality, his performance, his improv of lines, so we have some ridiculous southern sayings in there.
Now, Winnie, like I always say, you can't get lard unless you boil the hog. Didn't make sense until right now.
The more we recorded, the more we said, more Rufus, more Rufus, more Rufus, more Rufus. So that's all Diedrich.
Yeah, come on, Weenie. It's easier than lassoing a two-legged calf, which is fairly easy, I imagine.
Look at that. Last again. Why am I always last?
McSquizzy, don't mess with him. He's very, very tough. Doesn't care who you are, how big you are.
McFree, you're gonna pay for this! You big tube, you numpty, you big lassie's blouse! Are there any more meek-minded, yellow-bellied pansies?
What's your language, varmint? There's a lady present.
Billy Connolly, I'm gonna say he does bring a certain Scottish feeling to it, to the voice of McSquizzy. Do you know what I'm thinking? You know what I'm saying? You kind of get that feeling too?
Oh, did you think that up all by yourself, did you? Good observation.
He has a great Scottish accent.
I am peeling at him, Badgin, so am. Let's quit bumping the gums and get him a right jibbing.
He might be from like some sort of Scottish chipmunk squirrel clan.
Over here, a titanic battle ensued.
That defeated a bunch of British squirrels at some point hundreds of years ago.
Gregor!
Is it done yet? Did he do it? Is it over? Is it done? Did we do this? Is it over? Are we finished?
Oh, well, that was worth the wait. Right, everyone? Yeah.
It's really funny.
Yes, it's very
really funny.
We just decided to go for the silly and the funny, and we're still laughing.
Good job, good job. All right,
everybody. Y'all take it easy.
It was a thrill, and it was an honor, and it was a pleasure to be a part of this. I'm still thrilled that they even asked me to do it.
It's very exciting to be a part of Open Season 2. It's a good time.
It was great. I really, really enjoyed it, and this is something that I'm really proud to be a part of. Let's go.
Well, enough of that hullabaloo.
Yeah, it was crazy. It was great. I was very happy. I would come in, they would look at me, and they would say, well, let's give it a try again. And I would then have, I would take a coffee break for about 45 minutes. And then I would scream at them for the latte not being hot enough. And then I would march, just storm into the room, put on the headphones and go, I am here, ready to start speaking now, blah, 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 blah. And they were never ready. Then the director would come up to me and say, all right, read this line out loud. And then I would start reading it. I'd be like, hi, Boog. And then they go, wrong. And then I would do it again like 70 times. And then I'd finally, they would just be like, well, let's move on. We only have 3 hours left to get another sentence down. And so that's how it would go.
So it was really fun.
It's taken the last 7 years to do this. It's really fun.
Really fun.